Hi everyone, welcome to Lectures by Aparna. So today let's discuss about clipping circuits. This is the part 1 of clipping circuits. So what are clipping circuits? What is the function of a clipping circuit? If suppose we are having a circuit, consider there is a circuit in it and an input is coming and we will get an output from it. So the input wave will be a wave like this. We are considering the input wave like this. So what, this is the clipping circuit. What does this do to this input wave? A portion of the input wave will be clipped off. It may be at this portion. So the wave will look like this, or sometimes it may be the negative half cycle. In that case it will look like this. Without damaging the rest of the portion of the wave, a particular portion will be clipped off or removed. This is the function of a clipping circuit. So let's see what are the elements that come in a clipping circuit. For performing this function, we need a diode. Diodes will be used. Resistors will be used. Batteries will also be used. So a particular combinations, different combinations of these will perform clipping in different ways. Now going into the detail, I'll have to say something about diodes. Consider a diode. This will be the cathode of a diode and this is the anode of the diode. Okay, so in a circuit, if we keep a diode like this, if a positive come here and a negative voltage come here, if the cathode is more negative compared to the anode, this diode will be forward biased or it will be on. Okay, now in the reverse case, that is if a negative potential come here and a positive potential come here, if the cathode is more positive than the anode, then the diode will be reverse biased or it will be off. No current will be flowing through this diode. So in these circuits we are considering ideal diodes. Okay, so now let's move on to our clipping circuits. There are three types of clipping circuits: series clipper, shunt clippers, and biased clippers. In part 1, we are discussing about series clipping circuits. So let's see a series clipping circuit. And why is it called so? So I am drawing the clipping circuit. Let the diode be D and the resistance be R. The input coming here is V in and the output is V zero. Okay. Now let's see what is this clipping circuit doing. Since the diode D is in series with this input wave, it is called a series clipper. Depending on the position of the diode, we are calling it as series and shunt. In shunt, diode position will be parallel to the input wave. In series, the diode position is in series with this input wave. So this is a series clipping circuit. Now let's consider an input wave coming to this circuit. So this is a input wave. This is a input wave V in. This is V max and this is minus V max. So after coming through this circuit, the output voltage V0 of this will look like like this. This will be minus V max 0 and this is V 0. This is how the wave will look like. So I'll explain how this is happening. That is, the positive half cycles will be clipped off from this input wave, and hence it is called a positive series clipper. In positive series clipper, positive half cycles will be clipped off, and hence it is positive series clipper. Now let's discuss about the working of this clipping circuit. Consider positive half cycle coming here. So we are considering the positive half cycles coming here. So this will be plus and this will be minus. That is, this diode, the cathode of this diode will be more positive compared to the anode, and so this diode will be reverse biased, or it will be reverse biased means the diode is off. If the diode is off, what will happen to the circuit? Diode is off. There is no connection here. So at the output, the voltage V0 will be 0 during the positive half cycle. Okay. Now what happens? And hence the voltage, output voltage is 0 here during the positive half cycle. Now let's consider the case when negative half cycle comes here. What happens when a negative half cycle come here? So it is negative here and positive. So this cathode is negative compared to the anode. So the diode will be forward biased, or it will conduct. That is, this diode is on. So this circuit will look like this. So whatever is the input voltage, that will appear at the output. Okay. So that is the negative, in the negative half cycle, whatever is at the input, whatever signal is at the input, that will appear at the output. Again, in the positive half cycle, this diode will be off, and so the output voltage V0 will be 0. And in the next negative half cycle, diode will conduct and the output voltage will be same as that of the input. So this is how this clipping circuit works. Now let's consider the case when this diode direction is changed, when the direction of this diode is changed. So I'm going to keep the diode like this. What will happen here? The output of this circuit will look like V output. The positive half cycles will be there, negative half cycle won't be there. This is V max. Okay. That is, when the positive half cycle come here, this diode will conduct. This diode will be forward biased because the anode is more positive than the cathode. And so this diode will conduct. And so whatever is the input voltage, that will appear at the output. That is, in the positive half cycle, whatever is present at the input, it is coming at the output. And in the negative half cycle, what happens? The anode is negative than the cathode, so the diode will be reverse biased. That is, it will be off. When the diode is off, the output voltage will be 0. Again, in the next positive half cycle, this diode will conduct and the input signal comes at the output. In this way, this circuit is actually clipping off the negative half cycles. That is, the negative half cycles are being clipped here, and hence it is called a negative series clipper. Thus we discussed positive series clipper and negative series clipper. So to watch videos on shunt clippers, do watch the part 2 of this clipping circuits. Please do subscribe to this channel if you have liked this video. Thank you.